Please welcome the enchanting Marion Cotillard, everybody. Welcome to the show. You are, in fact, this is you on here, isn't it, in the front of the...
Yes, it is.
Welcome. Congratulations on all the reviews and the, business.
Thank you.
And you play Edith Piaf in this film.
Yes, I do.
She was a French singer, you know.
She was a French singer. She's still one of the famous French singers.
Yes, her and who's the other famous French singer that we would know in America? That is bound to be one. Barry Manilow. Barry Manilow. Yeah, no, he's French. For the purposes of this conversation, Barry Manilow.
Okay,
is French.
Barry Manilow.
Barry Manilow.
I would say Barry Manilow.
Oh yeah, Barry. We love him over here.
Yeah, yeah.
And is he still popular in his native France?
Oh, you can't believe how popular he is.
No, I'm sure he is. Yeah, yeah. So now, Edith Piaf, of course, had a tragic, very tragic life, didn't she?
She had.
Yes.
A very short life, and she was an extreme person.
Yeah. So is the film a comedy?
No, I mean, she can be funny.
She can. She could be funny when she's alive,
apparently.
Yeah, she
could be funny. But part of her life was so tragic that you remember the
Yes, but she was a great
part.
Torch song singer. She used to sing Je ne regrette rien, which is French.
At the end of her life.
Yes.
Well, maybe, but it's a good thing not to regret anything.
I regret nothing. I regret nothing. Je ne regrette rien.
Oh, you speak French.
Un petit peu. You spent a lot of time in Paris. Are you from Paris?
I'm from Paris.
Really? What part of Paris are you from?
Place des Vosges.
Oh, very nice.
Very
Yes.
Nice.
Hello.
But still popular.
Popular with whom?
Maybe it's not the right word.
No, it might be the right
word. It's like the popular area.
Yes,
it's not
it is.
So chic and
not chic.
Like
Mm-hmm. Well, it's nice though. I used to spend a lot of time next to Luxembourg Gardens in France. Do you ever go there?
Yeah, left bank.
Left bank. I'm a bit of a left bank type.
Yeah, I'm a right.
You're Rive Gauche. Rive Droite.
No,
yeah, I'm Rive
Gauche. I'm right bank type.
Yeah, that's also the perfume I wear. Rive Gauche.
Oh wow, it smells good.
Thank you. Oh, right now that's just desperation. That's the one I've been wearing since the monologue. It's a completely different one. Now, how are you? Your English is very good. Did you learn here in America?
Oh, thank you. First, it could be better, but I learned in England.
Really?
Yes.
Strange place to go.
In the
what
Kent.
Part?
Kent? Yeah.
Kent, yes, I've been to Kent. They call it the Garden of England.
Oh, yeah. So I learned in the Garden of England.
Right.
In a very weird house. But I was 12 at that time.
Really?
And but I kind of enjoyed it.
What, England?
Learning English. Working on it.
No, you're very, very good at it. Are you going to, of course, you'll have to do it for movie roles here. They'll insist that you do the script in English once you...
I guess.
Yeah, no, it's just a thing they do. The only person they let away with it was Arnold Schwarzenegger. He's the only one that they ever allowed to speak in his native language the whole time.
Oh, I didn't know.
He loved it. Now listen, if you're a Parisian kid, right, you're a French kid, you probably like the, are you into punk rock at all?
Not me.
Really? I thought all French kids were into punk rock.
No, but my brothers.
Ah.
They were.
Right.
I mean, maybe they still are.
Do you keep in touch with your family? Or have you lost them now you're famous? Get rid of them, I say.
No, I love my family.
All right, good.
And, but they ruined all my Sunday morning. As a child, it was like Sid Vicious, but at like 8 in the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
Every Sunday. So, but I kind of like punk rock, but at that time I didn't.
What kind of music do you listen to now?
Oh, I love Radiohead.
Radiohead, very good. You can get their album for free.
No.
Oh, sorry.
No, you can't do
that. Yeah, yeah, you can get it for free.
No, you can't.
All right.
If you love them, you can.
You pay music for the album on the internet. They're very...
Yes,
I ask you about Radiohead? Because I like Radiohead a great deal. I think they're a fantastic band. Why are they so grumpy?
Okay, so Like, you're going to learn me, teach me something.
Oh, grumpy,
something.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know what is grumpy.
Grumpy, it's a kind of, it's a, like a bad-tempered, like a ill-tempered, like
Oh,
a,
who cares? They're yes. doing great music.
Yes, no, you're right. They make great music. Listen, congratulations on the enormous success of this film. I am sure you're going to. It is an extraordinary performance. Really just spectacular. Thank you so much for coming out.
Thank you very much.
Marion Cotillard, everybody. We'll be right back. That looks good. I like that. Please welcome Marion Cotillard, everybody. Marion Cotillard. Lovely to see you again. How are you?
I'm good.
You sound good. American in this film. Are you American in this film?
Well, she's supposed to be American.
Yeah, no, she sounds American.
Fortunately, she has some French blood, so the flavor of French is not out of context.
I'm surprised. The last time you were here, you were very French. Now you're not so French as I remember you. Do you have you become less French in some way?
No, I didn't think so.
No, your English is very good. Have you studied
Thank
very
you.
Hard?
Yeah, I've been working on it.
I need a coach for the same thing.
No, I
actually.
Love your accent.
Oh, thank you very much. I see, now, when I speak French, badly, I admit, but when I speak French, French people usually go,
because you're funny.
I don't think that's it. That may be that, but I don't know. How is Paris? You live in Paris, don't you?
My base is in Paris, but I live where I work now.
You have a kind of gypsy, French gypsy life?
Yeah, well...
Do you play the violin?
No, I try to play guitar.
Do you really?
Yeah.
What kind of guitar?
A guitar.
Let me see if I can help you through this. You know how you get that? You know how you
like
get...
electric or like...
Yes, yes.
Wooden?
Wooden, yes.
Wood.
Oh, wood.
Wood, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, because when you play bad, it's, you know, you don't hear it that bad. With electric, you have, you know...
Well, you can turn the volume down on the electric guitar.
Yeah, but, well...
But why
point?
Bother? Yeah, because you were probably born to rock.
I'm on my way.
On your way to rock.
To rock,
What kind of music do you like to play then? French gypsy music?
Well, no, I'm more into American music, actually, right. But I'm a very bad player.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter about how you
play
it.
I play for myself.
Right, that's okay. I like the idea of you playing
yourself. I've tried the shower, but it really doesn't work.
So what you're saying is you play by yourself in the shower? Your English is a lot better, isn't it? Yeah. I used to be able to make fun of you doing this kind of thing. I can't. You're like,
hey.
No, that's good. Did you have a special coach, a teacher?
Yeah, I did. She was amazing. And she was very funny because she wanted actually me to forget about focusing on my accent. So we would play
focusing. You can come here any night of the week, darling. I'm telling you.
Focusing.
Say it again. Yeah, okay. I'm all about it.
No, can you say it?
Focusing.
Focusing. Yes, that is the way.
No, I say it legally. You say it illegally. It sounds a little bit like an English swear word. Are you familiar with the word?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. It sounds a little bit like that.
Well, it's not that far, actually.
As long as you focus. Yeah.
But my work was actually not that far. The word that I didn't.
How about the movie? How's the movie? What's the movie about? Johnny Depp's in it. He's handsome.
Yeah.
Yeah. He speaks French, doesn't he?
Yeah, but I didn't allow myself to speak French.
Oh, yeah, because you were doing that.
Because
yeah.
I was doing that thing.
Where did you make the film? Did you make it in America?
In Chicago, yeah.
Ooh, that's where they used to have gangsters, you know. Now, of course, they don't have any. No, they've got. They had a governor there, Governor Blagojevich. He was. He was focusing on the wrong thing.
Yeah, I heard stories.
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah.
He,
Yeah, I think a lot of people use the word focus about...
What about the gangster movie? You're a fan of the gangster movies? You like?
Yeah,
them?
I love gangster movies.
Yeah, it was the first thing I used to watch about in America when I was a kid. I used to watch black and white gangster movies, you know? Made me want to be a gangster in America.
You?
Yeah, yeah. You don't think I'd be a good gangster?
I think you are a kind of gangster.
You're my favorite guest of all time.
Really? Why would you say I was a guy? I mean, I love the idea of me being a gangster. I thought it was more a kind of like vulgar, desperate, needy, drunk uncle at a wedding or something.
Oh, no, but I don't know. I think there are a lot of gangsters on TV.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, boy, you're really nice, aren't you?
So, France then, how's that treating you? All right, you happy in Paris? Everything going okay there? You going to... Well, I know you say you live where you work.
Yeah.
But you got to go back there. It's France, it's springtime.
Sometimes, yeah. But yeah. I love my country, yes. Really. But I love traveling and, you know, discover new cultures.
Yeah? What's your favorite place you've been to, aside from America?
Peru.
Peru, you say? Yeah. Why now Peru?
And India. Peru, because people are nice and it's...
They're Peruvians.
Very energetic.
It's very country. Energetic?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've never been to Peru. I don't know.
You should. It's beautiful.
When people are energetic as opposed to lazy countries like. Canada. They're not. I don't think Canadians are lazy. I know. What are you saying, eh? No, I'm not. It was a joke. It's a joke. God. I'm sorry that, you know, sometimes I say the wrong thing. You got into trouble for that once, didn't you? You said the wrong thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. I remember that. Yeah, but, yeah. Oh, God, that was tricky.
But, you know, on TV, I'm very scared about TV, and I don't know what, half of my brain collapses.
No, I think, I do, that's what how the monologue is done here, but But I think what happens is if you... sometimes you can get involved in a discussion and end up saying things that you don't really mean. I know that happens to me a lot here. For example, I said something, you know, disparaging about Canada, a country which I love, by the way. Love. Not as much as America, but close. Like Canada, it's close to America. You don't care about my feelings about Canada, and I don't blame you. I want to talk about your movie too, but I don't know how to get back to it.
Do you want me to help you?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't know how. What should we do?
Well, what we should probably do is focus in some way.
Focus.
You but can say it again if you want.
Not...
Yeah.
I didn't
no,
say...
no. You don't say that. You get in trouble. Marion Cotillard, everybody. We'll be right back. I rather liked that. Please welcome the lovely Marion Cotillard, everybody.
I'm fine. How are you? You look lovely.
You look very chic. May I say even slightly French?
Well, actually, yeah, it makes sense, right?
Yeah, it does a little bit. How's the English going? You're sounding very good.
Well, thank you.
Yeah,
I'm
mine
still
is
working
coming along
on
too,
it.
Don't you think?
Yeah, yeah, you're losing your accent.
I know, I am. People in Scotland think I'm a traitor. People in France think you're a traitor because you speak another language other than French?
I don't think so.
No, I don't think they would.
I will keep my accent. Actually, each time I say... Oh, I hope I will say it the right way. Uh-huh. Focus?
Focus, yes.
Focus.
Yeah, when you said that the last time...
I think about you.
Well, we get into trouble when you say that on this show.
I said... Focus?
Focus, yeah. Focus is not the way to say it.
But now I say it right. But each time I say it, actually, I think about you.
I love that!
It's true.
I'm out of here. So long, suckers! I'm going to France to follow my dream. You've been very, very busy right now, haven't you? You've been doing... Were you at the Golden Globes last night?
Yes.
Did you get wet?
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
It was kind of fun.
Well, it's all right, isn't it? If you, you know, you get wet, it's the rain, it's okay.
It's just rain, as you said before.
Right, it's just rain.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you done anything else recently apart from, you know, going to awards and stuff? Anything exciting?
Here?
Anywhere.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, I went to a safari.
Shut up.
Why would I do that?
No, no, it's an expression. It means no way like that. I'm not like shut up. I'm not like ferme la bouche. I don't mean that. I mean, you know, I just, yeah, a little bit of French. Yeah. Oh, yes, yeah. I've been around French ladies before. Knock it off. Where did you go then on safari?
I went in Tanzania.
Tanzania?
Yeah. And it was, I mean...
Don't dare laugh at that. How dare you laugh at that? It's pronounced Tanzania here. It's Tanzania is pronounced here.
Again.
But Tanzania is fine. I knew what you meant. Tanzania. Yeah.
Tanzania.
Or Tarzana. Was it Tarzana?
Tanzania.
Tanzania.
Okay, Tanzania.
Right.
And actually, I love elephants, lions, and I had a crush. And it's true. I'm not just... I had a crush on warthog.
You had a crush on a warthog?
Yeah. Every time I would see a warthog, I wanted to cuddle the warthog.
So you're attracted to ugly, smelly creatures?
Totally.
I'm your man. I love that.
No, I thought you...
No, no, no. This is a snake cup. I drink the blood of snakes.
Smells like water to me.
It is water. It's sparkling. It's snake pee. Do snakes even pee? I don't even know if they pee, snakes, do they? I suppose they would.
Do they drink?
To excess. Actually, no, I don't think so. That's why there's no snakes in Ireland. They're all like, oh, no, here, no. Everyone drinks too much here. Let's get away over to Arizona. Or New Mexico. Have you ever been to New Mexico?
No.
You should go.
Yeah?
Yes, they don't know. I don't know if they have warthogs. They must have something similar, though.
I don't know.
Have you been around the U.S. at all?
Well, not really. I want to go to Yellowstone?
Oh, yeah, it's fantastic. Really... Yeah, I went skiing up there at the winter time. Yes, winter time. Yeah, just...
Wow.
Yeah.
Stop drinking.
All right, okay, sorry. Do you like going skiing?
I'm very bad at it.
Oh, so am I.
But you like it. Well, actually, I'm very bad at it, but I like it too.
That's exactly like me. I'm an enthusiastic amateur.
But I'm scared of trees. I love trees, but when I ski, it's like it's an aimant. No, on dit pas ça. Like something aimant? That attracts you.
Oh, like trees attract you. But
yeah,
you're frightened of them. Are you frightened
of
trees when you're not?
Last time I went to ski,
you hugged a tree?
I met a tree.
Oh, you crashed into a tree.
Absolutely.
Right, yes. Well, you want to stay on the big, wide, open bit.
I know. Yeah. I was told. I'm not that dumb, but I don't know.
I know that. I was just giving you a skiing tip.
Thank you, Greg.
That's all right.
I really needed it.
It was going so well for a while. Yeah,
Stay
in the white part.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you'll be all right.
Okay.
Are you frightened of trees normally? Like when you walk down the street, you see
trees.
A tree, you're like...
No, I love trees. Actually, right. I want to do a documentary about trees.
A documentary forests. About trees and forests?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, why this pause?
No, I'm just thinking about what any particular type of tree and forest you want. To do?
You know, reforestation, deforestation.
Oh, you mean like rainforest and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Have you ever been up the Amazon?
Yeah.
Have you?
In Peru.
Wow.
Yeah. With my very bad Spanish. I know that you
I speak terrible Spanish, although I do say hamburguesa.
Does it mean hamburger in Spanish?
Yes. Yes,
really?
Yes. Hamburger. It does.
Hamburguesa. Hamburguesa.
I think you pronounce the H in Spanish. No, you don't. Hamburguesa.
Hamburguesa. I don't know.
Comme français. Un peu.
Hamburger.
Yeah, hamburger. Yeah, but no H.
No.
Yeah. You don't use H's in France, do you? Not much.
I'm just wondering if it's something that I should understand.
It's not a trap. Not, it's not a trap, no. I'm just saying in French, you don't use the H's much.
We don't.
Yeah. No need for them.
No, I'm still scared
it's
on that.
It's not a trap. Why won't you trust me? Just because I lied to you once? We're out of time here, you know.
What?
We're out of time. We're out of time. We have come to the end.
Oh. Okay.
I said we have to do this in a very French way. I'm afraid, Marianne, it is over. We must no longer speak. Okay. It is time for the commercials.
Okay.
Well, go on then. Please welcome the beautiful Marion Cotillard, everybody. Marion. Hello.
Hello.
You look nice. I like what you've done with your hair. Oh. What's wrong? Is that your bra?
No, it's the mic.
Oh, it's Mike's bra.
Mike's bra.
Is that? Yeah. I thought it was a special tiny thin French bra for tiny.
No, it was really right. Mike's bra.
All right. Okay.
Do you know Mike?
Mike, yeah, the guy who wears the bra backstage, yeah. Yeah, he hits on all the girls. Wanna wear my bra on stage?
Well, I was kind enough to say yes.
May I say that your English is awesome? It seems
Thank
to
you.
Have really come along, much better than mine now.
So.
No, it's good. It's really good. And I like the straight hair. It's lovely.
Thank you.
I was going to do that. But
okay. You should.
I can't pull it off.
Why?
I don't know. I think I've got chubby cheeks.
I don't think so. I think
the film looks very nice. I said to them, it looks awesome. And they're like, no, it doesn't. And I was like, yes, it does.
What?
Yeah, no, they know nothing. Yeah, no, it looks awesome. Is it, you're on the boat with Leo and then does it sink and he dies?
Oh, yeah.
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 And then you survive on the door?
Yeah, and I'm the king of the world.
Yeah, yeah. That's not what happens, is it?
No.
This movie is shrouded in secrecy. No one's saying what it's about dreams, but that's all I can get out of anyone.
Yeah.
Why?
But I think it's because, you know, as an audience, myself, I love to be surprised and... Surprised.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Not scared.
All right.
Surprised.
Sorry. All right. Oh, ho! Yeah. Yeah, that was good.
No, but I think it's good when, you know, you don't know anything about an experience you will live in.
In the movie theater?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or, I don't know.
Elsewhere? In a park?
Tell me. Boring.
Parks are boring? Mm. You have to go to the right places.
Can you tell me?
No.
Oh, no.
No. But the movie's about, it takes place in dreams or something then, is it like?
Yeah, well it's
dream analysis, that kind of thing?
Not really.
Okay.
Because there are people who goes into other people's dreams.
Like Freddy Krueger.
Actually, yeah.
A little bit like Freddy Krueger, yes.
Yeah,
oh, see, that's awesome.
I mean, Leo DiCaprio doesn't really look like Freddy Krueger, but...
Dreamy Cougar.
Dreamy Cougar, yeah.
Yeah, so do you put much stock in dreams? Are you believe in dream analysis, anything like that?
I never been, you know, to see a shrink that...
Well, I'm qualified. Tell me some of your dreams and...
Okay.
All right.
Really often, I dream about the end of the world.
Uh-huh. That's a sex dream.
So what about when I dream about sex?
That's a sex dream.
Okay, so what about...
Sex dream.
Yeah, of course.
I'm a Freudian, you see? The Freudians believe that everything was real. Well, Freud believed it was all about sex, whereas the Jungians were like, oh, no, it's about unicorns and stuff. Do you study any of that at all? No.
Analysis?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. What else have you been up to? You've been singing with your, playing with that band? What do you do with that band?
Oh, well, singing, yeah. Well, everything is a big world, singing, playing bass guitar, playing drum and keyboards.
Is there anyone else in the band?
Well, like...
You do all of this?
No, I have my little space and I...
Nice.
Yeah. No, well, it's a French band. They sing in English, actually.
Really?
And I've known them for a long time, and they asked me... Yo de Lis.
Yo de Lis.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they asked me to do a duet with the singer,
right.
And I went to rehearse with them, and they asked me, well, would you do some bass guitar? I had never done bass guitar before, so I said, are you out of your mind? I cannot do that. And they said, well, let's just try. And I tried, and it was kind of not that bad.
But you just picked up a bass guitar you'd never played before, and you can play it. You're some kind of musical genius.
No. I always wanted to play bass guitar, so I guess I had the...
Had you played other guitars?
Kind of.
Right.
No, it's just that I'm good at starting... And learning things, but
right.
Then you have to practice to be really good.
Yes, so that's the same in America too.
I know. But then they asked me to play keyboards and then drums and then back voice, and I ended up being on stage with them the whole show.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, no, that's great.
And I changed my name.
To what?
Simone.
Simone.
Yeah.
That's my name, bitch.
Censored.
Yeah, I drew a penis on the bottom of the cup. It was during
a... No, it's here.
What? No, see, that's dream analysis right there with the snake.
Yeah.
There you are, you see?
What does that mean? The teeth, I mean...
The teeth of the penis?
Ooh. Yeah, I'm gonna drink.
Yeah, go ahead, have a drink. I'll have one too.
Cheers. So why is Simon your name?
It's not really. I was just being controversial. My nickname's Whiskey Pete.
What?
Whiskey Pete.
Whiskey Pete?
Yeah, Whiskey Pete, like Whiskey Pierre.
But like Whiskey...
Like Whiskey.
Whiskey.
Pierre.
Pierre. Oh, hi. Nice to meet you.
Whiskey Pierre. Et Simon.
And Simon.
Yeah.
We should do something together.
You bet we should.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, some nights I really love my job.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Marion Cotillard, everybody. Marion Cotillard.
Is an Oscar-winning actress. Her latest film, Rust and Bone.
And we traveled as a vaudeville act, I think.
What?
That was vaudeville. We did a vaudeville act.
What, Rust and Bone?
Yeah, that was us.
Okay. Anyway, the movie Rust and Bone is in theaters on Friday. Please welcome the beautiful Marion Cotillard, everybody. Marion Cotillard. May I say to you how elegant and beautiful you look this evening?
Thank
I mean, really,
you.
From very Parisian, may I say?
Well, yeah, it's actually very Parisian.
It is. I mean, yeah. It's very elegant. You look very nice. I like your shoes. They're pointy.
Yeah, they are.
Is it very difficult to walk in pointy shoes? You have to crunch your toes all up to one end.
Absolutely. I would love you to try, but I guess it's not gonna.
I don't know, man. Look at that, though. That's pretty exciting, isn't it?
You all have the same. All the men in the world have the same striped socks.
Yeah, but these are tights. all the way up.
Well,
I get very cold.
How can I be sure that it's tight?
Hey!
I'm sure
hey.
You want to know.
It's not married with children. Knock it off. How are you? You look well.
I'm good.
You look very beautiful. I like what you're doing with your hair. It's very
thank
kind
you.
Of...
Well, that's not me. I mean, I have someone doing this for
it's
me.
It's not your hair?
Oh, well, yes, it is.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
But someone does your hair.
Someone does that
happens everywhere, though. Lots of women have their hair done by other people.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just actresses, you know.
I know.
How are things in Paris? Are you still happily there?
I don't know, actually. The last time I went to Paris, I can't even remember where it was.
Really?
Yeah.
That makes me sad for you. I think of you as a very Parisian person.
My heart is so Parisian. I will always be Parisian. But how is Paris right now? I don't know, cold, probably.
Because you're not there, Marianne, that's why.
Oh, that's sweet.
Hey. It's the first time I've ever talked to a French woman on the show.
Oh, you're such a liar.
What are you talking about?
I don't know about me to begin with.
No.
It must be my fourth time.
I think you've been here more than that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, five times, yeah.
Five.
Yeah, five times. Well, I like you.
I mean, I like you too. Okay.
Let's take a drink.
Yeah. Cheers.
Salut. So, tell me about the film then, Rust and Bone. Is it about Jeff and I?
Oh my God, he's much smaller and...
That happens a lot in TV. You think people are taller. And then you meet them and like, oh, they're much smaller, yeah.
Joff? That's his name. Joff. Hi, Joff.
Hello, darling.
You look amazing. I just thought you were taller.
I think the last time you were here, Jeff was in his early days, wasn't he? He wasn't talking much.
No.
No, those were good times.
You,
yeah. Well, things have changed a bit. So, Rust and Bone, then, it's about a guy and a girl.
Yeah, it's a love story.
That's what I thought.
It's a very unusual love story.
Why?
But, well, because it was two people who were not meant to meet each other. And what?
I don't think I've ever seen a film like this.
You're mean.
I wasn't saying it to be mean. No, I didn't.
What?
Look, I was.
Someone talking to you?
I'm sorry. That was stupid. It was a stupid joke.
No,
I didn't say it to be mean.
No, but you're right.
But they shouldn't be together.
I mean, I have no leg in the movie. Have you ever seen that?
You play no legs?
Yeah.
How do you do that?
Well, I'm so good.
I feel we haven't seen each other for a while, and it's difficult. It's difficult not to see you. I feel like you're you and I'm Paris.
We were supposed to meet in Paris, but...
You were having a baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, that gets in
you
the way
too.
Sometimes. Well, I had... I told you this, it was there. I was outside the Café Rostand near the park.
Yeah.
And I saw you go by with, I suspect, your baby and other members of your family.
Mm-hmm.
And you looked like you were having the same kind of time as I was having with my son was 4 months at the time, my youngest boy, and he was screaming and yelling, and yours looked like it was doing kind of the same thing, and you were all like, oh
my God.
Yeah.
Was I?
And that's why I decided to just let you go and not go, hey, hi, how you doing? But I did see you, and I told all of them, and they said, no, but it was you, wasn't it? Sure.
I don't, yeah, maybe. My baby's pretty calm, but...
Yeah, the baby, I think, was calm. The rest of you looked,
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
You didn't look, it wasn't anything going on. You just looked, everyone looked pretty tired. And,
Of course.
Yes, I know.
But you know.
I do. My son is now
sleeping.
Almost two. Is your baby sleeping yet?
Yeah. I mean, thanks God he is now.
A little bit?
But
or a lot?
It took him a very long time to go to sleep.
Yeah, so. No, that happens to me. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe we can sleep now.
Yeah, well, this is like, the only rest I get.
We have to catch up on sleeping.
Is it creepy if I just sit here and watch you sleeping? We'll take a break. We'll be right back with Marion Cotillard. I'm here with Marion Cotillard. We're discussing things in French.
Yeah.
See?
Actually, it's oui.
Oui or yeah. Oui.
Oui. Yeah. Or if you're in Quebec or parts of Canada.
Ah.
Have you heard the French they speak up there? It's not like French at all. It's like, ah!
I have nothing to say.
You should have been here for the monologue.
Oops.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
Hey, did you learn English from watching movies? Is that how you did it?
No, because Charlie Chaplin, he doesn't talk that much.
There's been movies since then.
Yeah, Jaws.
Jaws, yeah. Well.
And.
Try saying, we're. Écoutez et répétez.
D'accord.
We're going to need a bigger boat.
We're going to need a bigger boat.
Very good! Very good. All right. We're out of time. Can I tempt you with a piece of fruit?
How long have they been here for?
Actually, about a week.
That's okay.
Oh, the lady apple. Yeah, I thought you might go for that. No. Coconut?
Yeah.
Coconuts are nice, aren't they?
Yeah. Just trying.
No, you can
Where's
have
that?
It. This is, it's called a sweet mammy or a sweet mammy. I'm not quite sure.
Sweet mammy?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
You know what mémé means in French?
What?
It's grandma.
Oh, well, that's your grandma right there, then. You're
right.
No, it's not your actual grandma. It's a piece of fruit.
Yeah, you just said that it was my grandma.
I did say that. Look at these pineapples. Oh, you... Look at that.
Kissing my grandma. This is... Yeah? What's going on?
I'm not entirely sure.
Where does this come from?
Well, when a man and lady banana love each other very much.
Okay,
so you're taking the coconut, the grandma and
no,
the...
I'm going to take this.
Oh, you surprised me. Marion Cotillard, everybody. We'll be right back. I did get a word of that. The beautiful and talented Marion Cotillard, everybody. Sensational!
Thank you.
I mean, you couldn't be more French. I mean, well, you could, I guess,
I
but
could, well, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I love the thing and the shoes. Good Lord!
Yeah, crazy.
They are. Can you walk really much in those?
Well, not for long.
Yeah. Like, what age is your baby now?
3 and a half.
Can you carry the baby wearing those shoes?
I actually could.
Could you really?
You know, a mother can do
yes,
a lot of
I know,
things.
Special magic powers. I am.
Absolutely.
I like them a lot. How are you?
Do you want them?
Yes.
I can give you them as a gift, you know, for...
For what? Because I'm interested and I am listening.
Just for fun. Because I would love to see you in yours in those shoes, maybe.
I think
I think...
What do you think?
I think possibly you look better in those shoes than I do. But I haven't seen you in some time. You look very well. You seem happy.
I am.
Are you really?
Thank you, yeah.
Good. It must be motherhood, I think.
Well, yeah.
Because when I first met you, it was before you were a mother, and you came here and you were very sad and pouty and French.
I was crying.
Yeah.
I remember. I was totally depressed.
Yeah, yeah. But now you're cheerful.
Yeah.
Which makes me think, are you in therapy?
I'm not, but...
Come on, let's do something.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Ah. Okay. All right. Go ahead. Take your time. All right. Just relax. Actually, it's therapy we're doing. We're not shampooing your hair. Unless you want a shampoo. Do you want a shampoo? Come on, we'll do a shampoo.
Okay.
So... I have to say,
this
you look...
This is a massage. This is not a shampoo.
I don't want to actually use shampoo because I suspect there's a team of publicists backstage right now who are very, very upset at what I'm doing. Can I tell you, though, that being upstream from you, you smell so good.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and your scalp is in great condition. So...
Thank you very much.
All right, but a
therapy.
Yeah, why not? I mean, are you in therapy?
I'm not. No, I'm not. But, I mean, I am right now, of course.
Okay, right, fair enough then. Let me ask you, is it weird, and I'm asking for a friend, is it weird to be sexually attracted to mice? Are you sexually attracted to mice?
No,
that's interesting, because what happened there is you made it about you.
I'm an actress.
Yes, you are, and a very good one, too. You know
Is it sexually attracted with mice?
I'm asking for a friend. It's not for me.
Well, if you're a mouse, it's not weird.
That's very good. You see, that's why existentialism became so popular with the French.
See?
Because you think about things all the way round. Existentialist.
Questions
very
in the brain
good.
All the time.
Do you ever sit in cafes and just think about groggy?
I don't like it. No. I think about
croissant.
But not sitting in a cafe.
She can say that, can't she? She's French, man! She's won a Oscar! I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm so sorry. He is so rude.
Rude.
Oh, Michael, he's a racist.
Because I said...
Ooh la la! Yeah, no, he hates French people.
You said it first.
Who, I said it first? Baguette. Did I?
Yeah.
Oh, it must have slipped out inadvertently.
Yeah, it's your French...
Yes,
you know.
I'm iconoclastic, you see. I'm a maverick, can't be tamed. I ramble through life.
That's good.
Yes, a little bit. I'm going to France soon, you know.
Where?
France. Oh, I see. What part of France? Paris.
Well,
I'm going to Paris.
Yeah, that's good.
And I'm going to Brussels.
Brussels is
amazing. That's in Belgium, though.
I know.
You ever been there?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
I love it. I wanted to live there.
In Brussels?
Yeah. Well, I fell in love with
a Brussels
Belgian guy. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Recently?
Long time ago.
Oh, right. I get it. Okay. Say no more.
Oh, slow down.
Yeah. No, I get it. Okay. Did you ever see that statue of the little boy doing the pee-pee in Brussels?
The mannequin.
French. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
I like that thing.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Do you think it's water or beer? Coming
from his little pee-pee?
His pee-pee, yeah.
I think it's water. I don't think Belgians would waste good beer like that, do you?
Beer.
Do people drink out of that? Australians.
Or French drunk actress.
Did you do that?
No.
Oh, so you're telling me you have a friend who is a French actress who at one point in her life was drunk and in love with a Belgian man.
Absolutely.
And went and drank the water from the little pee-pee boy's fountain thing.
Absolutely. Tall. Blonde.
She was tall and blonde and not you in any way.
No.
Okay.
I was with her and I tried to stop her. I never drink.
Really? You don't drink? Maybe a glass of wine with a croissant or something?
Not croissant. A glass of wine.
A glass of wine with a glass of wine?
Yeah.
God, I love the French.
One after another.
Yeah.
So I'm going to Paris, is what I'm saying. I'm going to Paris. I'm going to be there. I'll come over and look you up.
Yeah, okay. Let's have a glass of wine.
Oh, no.
What?
Well, you can have a glass of wine, but if I have a glass of wine, then, you know,
crikey, I'm
going to go cray.
Said it again.
Things will
zoot alors.
Oh, no. Jacques. Say it, but that I had to say it then for legal reasons.
Well, you
that's exactly
need
what would
to
happen.
Explain.
Well, you see, when I drink alcohol, have you ever seen the paintings of Jackson Pollock?
Yes.
That's what's in my head after.
It costs a lot of money.
It costs a lot of money if I drink alcohol. Yeah. There's the cops, there's the fire department, there's the helicopters, there's the search and rescue.
Oh, yeah, you go serious drink.
Oh, I was really bad. Yeah, you never been into drink or hard drugs or anything?
Hard drugs, no. Drink, yeah, I have to confess.
You got a little bit of drink? Yeah, but you probably drink like most French people drink, which is reasonably. Okay, maybe you don't, I don't know.
Well, it's good for you. When you come to Paris, you're going to learn a lot about French and how they drink.
I've spent quite a lot of time in Paris, actually.
So?
Did you just sew me on an American top? You sewed me! You were like, sew? I haven't been sewed by a French girl in about 15 years, and I liked it!
Good, I'm happy you're happy.
You sewed me, so?
So?
No, I'm just saying, I'm looking forward to it, is what I'm saying.
Well, it's good, yeah. Have fun.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
What about holidays in France? Where should I go? The south?
Southwest.
Southwest?
Near Bordeaux, they have very good wine, first of all.
No, look, I think I have to explain to you about the wine. I've also gone on this diet where I don't eat cheese. Maybe I shouldn't go to France.
Maybe.
Have you ever tried that? I'm a vegetarian. I'm vegan.
You're vegan?
I've gone vegan, yeah. Like I'm vegan crazy.
Vegan crazy?
Yeah, I don't eat cheese or meat or no animal proteins in my body at all. None.
Okay, that's good. Well, there's no animal protein in raisins.
That's true.
That's true.
And I'm looking forward to having some, but we have raisins in California.
You do?
We're famous for them. The California raisins, they were huge. Well, they were tiny, but they were. They were what they were. Oh, we should talk about the movie. It's in French.
Yeah, it's in French.
Yes.
And I have a Belgian accent. Maybe, yeah.
That's. I thought I picked that up.
I knew. Yeah.
Yeah.
Saw you watching and I saw in your bed, oh my God, she has a Belgian,
Belgian accent. Yeah. What is a Belgian accent? Like, if we pick a phrase, say, je m'appelle Marianne, if you said that in a Parisian accent and then said it in...
In what? In a what?
A Parisian accent.
In Parisian, yeah.
Right. So if you said je m'appelle Marianne in a Parisian accent, it would sound like
je m'appelle Marion.
Oh, God, that's so great. All right, now try saying it in a Belgian accent.
Je m'appelle Marion.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Well, it's subtle.
Yes,
obviously.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, do they use different words, is what you're saying?
Well, sometimes, you know, like Canadian French.
Like Canadian French. Oh, God, don't start with that. We talked about that before, and the Quebecois came here, all of them, and they were angry at me.
Oh, wow. So.
And I think they were angry. They just kept going,
Canadian talk like that?
Only the French Canadian. Regular Canadians are like, sorry. We have to take a commercial break.
Let's do this.
Oh, God. Let's take a commercial break instead. We'll be right back with Marion Cotillard. I'm here with Marion Cotillard, who uses a Belgian accent in her next film. So look out for that. Yeah. Anyway, we're out of time.
So what do we do?
As a species, or just... well, we could end with an awkward pause, or...
What would be yours?
You would be mine.
Wow. I would be your awkward pause?
Yes, you would.
How do I do that?
You're doing it.
Okay. I try to remember for next time.
There is no next time.
I know.
But we'll always have West Hollywood. Doesn't sound the same, does it? We'll always have Paris might sound better.
We'll always have Paris, yeah?
Yeah. Well, you will. You're French.
You will have too.
Yeah, I'll get over there. So, there you go then.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to try something. What are you looking for in Paris?
Do I sound like that to you?
No, I was a little low. I mean, my voice was low. I'm very bad at impersonating.
I don't know if you are very bad at impersonating. I think you're very good. I think you're very good at playing me.
I'm very happy about that.
Me too. We're out of time, though.
Okay, well, what
Well, then get out of here. All right, I'm going.
Okay, I'm going.
All right, Marion Cotillard, everyone.